Hello everyone, I am Mrs. Sunita Dole, working as an assistant professor in Computer Science and Engineering Department of Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Topic covered here is writing a grammar topic of syntax analysis. Grammars are capable of describing most but not all of the syntax of programming language. For example, the requirement that the identifiers be declared before they are used cannot be described by context-free grammar. Therefore, the sequence of tokens accepted by a parser form a superset of programming language, and subsequent phases of a compiler must analyze the output of the parser to ensure the compliance with the rules that are not checked by the parser. Here we consider the transformations that are useful for rewriting the grammar so that they become suitable for top-down parsing. In previous video, I covered the two topics, that is, the role of the parser and the context-free grammar. Now, in this video, I am going to cover the topic writing a grammar. Learning outcome. At the end of this session, students will be able to write a grammar for a given non-deterministic finite automata, eliminate the ambiguity from the given grammar, and identify the non-context-free languages. Regular expression versus context-free grammar. Every regular expression that can be described by regular expression can also be described by a grammar. We can convert a non-deterministic finite automata into a grammar that generate the same language as recognized by the non-deterministic finite automata. Now, consider the procedure to convert a non-deterministic finite automata into a grammar. Step 1. For each state I of the NFA, create a non-terminal symbol capital AI. Step 2. If state I has a transition to state J on input symbol A, then introduce the production capital AI derives A capital AJ. Step 3. If state I goes to state J on the input symbol epsilon, then introduce the production capital AI derives capital AJ. Step 4. If state I is an accepting state, introduce capital AI derives epsilon. Consider the non-deterministic finite automata given below. There are 4 states in the given non-deterministic finite automata. So create the 4 non-terminal symbols A0, E1, E2 and E3 corresponding to Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3. State Q0 has transition to state Q0 on symbol A and B and has a transition to state Q1 on symbol A. Hence, introduce the production A0 derives small a capital A0 or small b capital A0 or small a capital A1. State Q1 has a transition to state Q2 on symbol B. Hence, introduce the production capital A1 derives B capital A2. State Q2 has a transition to state Q3 on the symbol B. Hence, introduce the production capital A2 derives B capital A3. State Q3 is an accepting state, so introduce capital A3 derives epsilon. Till now, we consider how to convert a non-deterministic finite automata into a grammar. Now, pause this video and reflect on this question for a minute or 2 minutes and write your response. Once you return the answer to this question, then you can restart playing this video. The question is, write a grammar for the following non-deterministic finite automata. I hope all of you have completed this activity. So the question was, write a grammar for the following non-deterministic finite automata. Since there are 3 states in the given non-deterministic finite automata, so create the 3 non-terminal symbols A0, E1 and E2 corresponding to Q0, Q1 and Q2. State Q0 has transition to state Q1 on symbol A. Hence, introduce the production capital A0 derives A capital A1. State Q1 has a transition to state Q2 on symbol B. Hence, introduce the production capital A1 derives B capital A2. State Q2 has transition to state Q2 on symbol A and B. Hence, introduce the production capital A2 derives A capital A2 or B capital A2. State Q2 is an accepting state, so introduce the production capital A2 derives epsilon. Eliminating ambiguity, a grammar that produces more than one past T for some sentence is said to be ambiguous. For the most passive, the grammar must be unambiguous. Unambiguous grammar means unique selection of the past T for a sentence. Sometimes, an ambiguous grammar can be rewritten to eliminate the ambiguity. As an example, we shall eliminate the ambiguity from the following dangling else grammar. Statement derives if expression then statement, or if expression then statement else statement, or other statement. Here, other statement stands for any other statement. According to this grammar, the compound conditional statement if E1 then S1, else if E2 then S2, else S3 has the past T as shown in figure. The grammar is ambiguous since the string if E1 then if E2 then S1 else S2 has the two past T as shown in figure. In all programming languages with the conditional statement of this form, the first past T is preferred. The general rule is match each else with the closest previous and match then. We can rewrite this grammar as the following unambiguous grammar. The idea is that the statement appearing between a then and an else must be matched, that is, it must not end with the unmatched then followed by any statement, for the else would then be forced to match this unmatched then. A matched statement is either if then else statement containing no unmatched statement, or it is any other kind of unconditional statement. Grammar after eliminating the ambiguity is statement derives matched statement or the unmatched statement. Matched statement derives if expression then matched statement else matched statement or other statement. Unmatched statement derives if expression then statement or if expression then matched statement else unmatched statement. This grammar generates the same set of strings, but it allows only one passing for the string, namely the one that associate each else with the closest previous and match then. This is the second example of eliminating the ambiguity from the grammar. So this grammar represents the simple arithmetic expression. Non-context-free language constructs. There are some language construction in the programming language which are not context-free. This means that we cannot write a context-free grammar for these constructions. Example, L1 equals to WCW such that W is in A or B star. This language L1 consists of all the words composed of a repeated string of A's and B's separated by a C. This language is not context-free. This language abstracts the problem of checking that the identifiers are declared before their use in a program. That is, the first W in WCW represents the declaration of an identifier W, and the second W represents its use. L2 equals to A raised to N, B raised to M, C raised to N, D raised to M such that N and M is greater than equals to 1. This language is not context-free language. L2 consists of strings in the language generated by the regular expression A star, B star, C star, D star, such that the number of A's and C's are equal and the number of B's and D's are equal. L2 abstracts the problem of checking that the number of formal parameters in the declaration of the procedure agrees with the number of actual parameter in a use of procedure. L3 equals to A raised to N, B raised to N, C raised to N, such that N is greater than equals to 0, that is, strings in language of A star, B star, C star with equal number of A's, B's and C's is not context-free language. But the language similar to L1, L2 and L3 are context-free. Example, L1 dash equals to WC W raised to R such that W is in A or B star, where W raised to R stands for the reverse of W, is a context free, and the grammar for the same is given below. L2 dash equals to A raised to N, B raised to M, C raised to M, D raised to N, such that N and M is greater than equals to 1. It is a context free language and the grammar for the same is given here. L2 dash equals to A raised to N, B raised to N, C raised to M, D raised to M, says that N and M is greater than equals to 1, is context free, and the grammar for the same is given below. L3 dash equals to A raised to N, B raised to N, such that N is greater than equals to 1, is a context free, and the grammar for this language is S derives A, capital S, B, or AB. This is the reference. Thank you.